here's the deal. We are in the garden, right? And everything is great. And there's this tree, okay? And the man says, ooh, see that tree? You don't eat the fruit of that tree. That apple, you do not eat. So he goes inside, you know, names some animals, I don't know, maybe takes a dump. Anyway, what does she do? What does she do? She eats the apple. I can't believe what I'm saying. He says, don't eat it. She eats it. Unbelievable. I tell you, man, since then, you know, men, women, I don't know, it's all going wrong.
So inviting, so exciting. Whenever you're near, I hear a symphony.
Miserable marriage. Wedding canceled. Remarried. Divorced again. Irreconcilable sexual disharmony. Dysfunctional marriage. Divorce. Divorce. Divorce, 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 divorce. Well, talk to me.
We had a bad run.
Things have changed down there. Men and women, they're not like they used to be.
Yeah? Well, things are changing up here as well, okay? I'm getting pressure from above, if you know what I mean. For results. For men and women to be bonded in eternal bliss. In the meantime, I've been instructed to introduce new incentive schemes for our leading operatives.
Leading operatives, huh?
That's you.
Skip the flattery, Gabriel. Where's the beef?
It's a hard case to crack. But I have full confidence that you can do it. If you don't, you don't come back.
What?
No way.
That's the new incentive scheme. Your mission is to unite man and woman, blah, 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 okay? When you're done, you come back. If you fail, stay down there forever.
You are not serious.
Liberatum money. It's out of my hands.
Thank you. She's the secret daughter of Marilyn Monroe and John F. Kennedy, right? I mean, that's why Marilyn was murdered. So, the young girl grows up in an orphanage, unaware of her incredible parentage. Years go by. She's beautiful. She's smart. She's successful, okay?
Then what?
Well, then she gets sent to London as U.S. ambassador.
Where she discovers who she is and also unravels the secret of the Nazi gold hidden underneath the embassy.
Yeah.
It's kind of obvious, Robert.
Of course it's obvious, guys. It's a trash novel. You buy it in the airport. You take it on holiday. Nice to see you down here. I'd love to stay and talk, but you don't have to. Nice trick, Celine.
Wanna try your luck?
With the gun?
With the fruit.
I don't have time for games.
If you're afraid, Elliot, why don't you just say so?
Celine, last night we discussed a certain proposal.
And I said no, because you cheat, Elliot.
Okay. So I'm flirtatious. It's in my nature. But Celine, I want you to think again. Do you have any idea how difficult it is for a woman to find a good husband in this town, let alone a good dentist? Celine, I'm serious. Robots? You're trying to tell us that we're going to be replaced by robots? The robots are going to get down on their little robot hands and knees and clean the dust out of every corner of every office in this building. I think not, Miss Kostetin.
Well, at least the robot won't spend its time writing a trash novel. Not even a very good trash novel, as I understand it.
Oh, I see. This is personal.
This has nothing to do with me, Robert. This comes right from the top, from Mr. DeVille himself.
Well, then perhaps it's time I spoke to this Mr. DeVille.
It's too late. You're fired.
Ready?
Mm-hmm.
Now, if you move, the offer's canceled.
Okay. Mm-hmm. Wait, Celine?
Don't speak.
Do you think this is wise?
Puts me off.
Stop!
Mayhew? Would you call a doctor?
It would be a pleasure, madam.
This time of day.
Finally.
Well? Answer me.
Lily, I got fired. They replaced me with a robot.
Yeah, well, I know how they feel.
Hmm?
Look, I've been meaning to tell you this for a while now, and it seems like as good a time as any. Robert, I'm leaving you.
You're leaving? What are you talking about?
His name is Ryan. He teaches aerobics. We're in love. We're moving to Miami.
Lily, how can you do this to me? A time like this?
I want a man, not a dreamer.
I don't know what to say. We could talk about this. I'll get another job. We'll sort everything out.
Sorry. But as of tonight, You're going home alone.
Lily!
Lily? Lily?
Mr. Robert Lewis?
Yeah, that's me.
My name is Jackson. This is my associate, Ms. O'Reilly. And we're from the Firm but Fair Eviction and Collection Agency. Now, I have a list of certain items that we're empowered to collect under federal and state law in lieu of unpaid debts. And furthermore, we are contracted to serve upon you notice of eviction from these here premises forthwith.
I beg your pardon?
We can do this with violence or without, it's up to you. The client pays our medical bills, but not yours. Well?
Oh, without, please.
Good choice.
Have any idea how difficult it is to find a good husband in this town? Or a good dentist, come to that. Playing this sort of game, you have disgraced yourself once again. Well, you caught him through the frontal lobe, so apparently you'll live. But he'll never practice orthodontics again, that's for sure. My main fear in all this is that you're going to end up like your mother, who long ago found her own natural level in society. That is to say, she scuttles along the bottom.
Her biggest problem was marrying a man like you. A mistake I've taken great care to avoid.
You are gonna go to work, my girl.
What?
You spent a quarter of a century watching the time go in and out. But from tomorrow, you are gonna work. Here, under my supervision, you're going to learn the essence of business. About money and how it flows relentlessly back towards he who owns it. How to generate a profit from a loss from a profit. You aren't gonna work. Now, this may not strike you as very palatable. It may make you want to vomit. But you will, I assure you, get used to the taste. And pretty soon you'll be spooning it down and asking for more like all the other kids.
Job back. I want my hat before, Mr. Neville, and I'm gonna count to five, and if you don't oblige me, I'm gonna kill you. One, two, three.
Nothing to be ashamed of without access to a proper education. And
shut up!
I was just trying to help.
Yeah, well, I don't need any help.
Die for this. I swear to God, you won't
die
for this.
No.
Shoot him again. In the head this time, I'll count to five.
Shut up! Who are you anyway?
Nobody!
I'm his daughter.
Drive!
drive more carefully.
He cut in on me.
Mirror, signal, Minerva.
Sir, my name's Walt. I'm here to help you in any way I can during your visit to us, be it short or long, and whether it is purely for refueling purposes or for the use of our extensive washroom and retail facilities.
Is this a gas station, Walt?
Oh, it sure is, sir.
Well, then fill it up with gas and cut the crap.
Guy was just doing his job. He was just trying to be helpful. You're in a lot of trouble, you know? My father's gonna have you killed. You realize that? Tortured first, naturally. Then he's gonna have you killed.
What if I let you go?
I don't know. What do you think? Think he's just gonna forgive you?
Wait a minute. Why would I ask him to forgive me? Your father treated me like a piece of shit. Like I was nobody. Just because I was a cleaner, like I was disposable.
Well, that's the tank full, sir.
Thank you, Walt.
That's for you, Walt. You're a man, Walt. Not a slave. Not a machine. Don't let anyone ever treat you otherwise. Go on.
Now let's get this clear. I'm not going to hurt you, but I am the kidnapper. And you are the
victim.
And that's just the way it is.
It's okay, I've been through this before.
Kidnapped before?
Yeah, I was 12.
God, that's terrible.
It was a long time ago.
So, how am I doing?
In the kidnap?
Yeah.
So far, you're not doing too bad.
Thank you. Anyway, I'm just tying you up so you can't escape in the night.
I know that.
Because, of course, you would.
Are you gonna try to have sex with me?
No.
Isn't that what you brought me up here for?
No, it's not.
It didn't even cross your mind.
No. Well, no.
Do you have a problem with sex?
No.
Oh, so you're just frightened of it?
No.
Nervous then?
Look,
I'm not nervous.
Okay, then calm down.
I'm perfectly calm. I'm just trying to explain to you that there's no sexual motives for my actions.
Glad we got that cleared up.
So what did they do next?
They put a needle in my arm and took a pint of blood and sent it to my father. Next week they did the same the next week till he paid up. He waited 6 weeks. That's what happens to the victim.
Sing for ya, 'cause they already know ya.
Enjoying the book?
No.
What's it about?
It's a romance. This girl meets this guy. They fall in love. It's bullshit.
I'm writing a novel myself. A lot of people say that, but in my case, it's true.
I'm not interested in you or your novel or any other pathetic ambition you have to change your miserable, mundane existence.
Do you want some exercise?
No.
You can't say no. It's not part of the arrangement.
I want to read my book.
You just said it was bullshit.
It doesn't mean I'm not enjoying it.
You just said you weren't.
A girl can change her mind, can't she? She heard his breathing become shallow, and a flicker of a smile chased across her lips as she meditated on the power she now held over him. Are you sure you want to catch that flight? She asked.
Do you think they're in love yet?
No.
If they are in love, we could go home. I hate it down here. I hate the air. I hate the food. I hate the plumbing.
Deeper, unable to stop.
I ache all over.
This indeed was perfect.
I sweat and the heat and I ache and the cold. Why can't we stay someplace decent?
Budget doesn't cover that.
Exactly. Why not?
You know those mysterious ways you keep hearing about, Jackson? Well, this is one of them. A voice called a glued engaged. She let her hand drift down towards the bulge of his passion.
I remember the good old days.
She heard his breathing become shallow.
All you had to do was introduce a man or a woman. Nature did the rest.
She gasped with surprise and delight.
Doesn't work like that anymore.
While a frisson of light erupted between her thighs, as she sensed the firm exploratory pressure of his swollen flesh.
It's all gone to shit.
Sure has. In the hidden recess of her pelvis, their bodies fused into one writhing mass of torrid sexual. I don't eat red meat.
You could eat the vegetables.
They're on the same plate.
So?
I'm not gonna eat this.
Do you eat fish and poultry?
Yes.
But not red meat?
No. Or eggs, unless I know they're free range.
Well, then why didn't you tell me you don't like meat?
Because you didn't ask. And as a matter of fact, I do like meat. I just don't eat it. Moral reasons, if you must know. And if you had taken the time to
acquire... Why are you such a pain to be with?
Because you tied me to a chair all night. Because I'm the victim. And you are the kidnapper, apparently.
Meaning exactly what?
Kidnap for Beginners, Chapter 1. Have you even asked for a ransom yet?
Don't say a word until I tell you. Hello, Mr. Neville. It's me. Now, I want my... Me. The kidnapper. Right. Now, what I want... It's not like that. That's unfair now. I would... What are you doing?
No, what are you doing?
I'm negotiating with your father.
Did you get very far?
Well, it kept interrupting.
Right.
Wouldn't let me finish.
Remember what they didn't teach you at Harvard Business School, okay?
I didn't go to Harvard Business School.
It's a figure of speech, Robert.
Oh. Sorry.
Negotiation is weakness. You are the kidnapper. You demand and he complies. You go in hard, and you go in fast.
Hard and fast.
Right. I'm you. You grasp that? Okay. Pretend it's ringing you. Psych yourself up. Go to your dark side. Okay. He answers.
All right, you motherfucker. I've got your daughter here, and I'm gonna send her back in pieces if I don't get what I want. You hear me? I'm gonna pull her fingers out with pliers, and then I'm gonna fry them up for breakfast. Do you understand?
And so on like that, okay? For no longer than 30 seconds. What?
Hello there, Mr. Neville. Now...
Right, you asshole, I've got your daughter here, and I'm gonna cut her up and post her home to you in boxes! Small boxes! Right, daughter, I've got your asshole here, and I'm gonna send it. Right, right. Now I
can't speak to anyone. I need to speak to him. Hello? Yeah, I can hold. Right, listen, you asshole. I got your daughter here, and I'm gonna send her back in pieces unless... Oh, I'm sorry, madam. No, I must have dialed the wrong number. No, I haven't got your daughter here. I have someone else's. No, we're not married. Yes, I've read the same thing. It's very hard to find suitable young men these days. Well, I'm sure your daughter's very nice. In principle, I've got no objections to meeting her. What is the problem?
You should just send her in.
You've done this kind of work before?
We do everything. Eviction and debt collection are our daily bread, but personal retrieval, bounty hunting, you name it, we do it.
How much?
Our fee for the recovery of your daughter is $100,000.
That's a lot of money.
$5,000 advance. The rest is cash on delivery, no daughter, no dough.
Naturally, we'd operate a sliding scale, whereby if we only bring back part of your daughter, we only get part of the money.
That's enough, Jackson.
No, I mean, if he's cut her ears off, we can't find him, well, we'll knock a couple thousand off the tariff. More for limb, obviously.
Jackson.
Sorry.
Mr. Neville, I don't think you need to worry. My partner is simply envisaging a worst-case scenario.
What about the kidnapper?
You want him too? That's extra.
What if he gets in the way?
We'll deal with that situation if it arises.
What if I want him to get in the way?
Let us speak plainly, Mr. Neville. You want we should kill him?
Yes. No one's asking you, Mayhew.
$200,000.
Including expenses?
Including all expenses, except medical costs, for which you accept full and unlimited responsibility.
Only for the duration of the contract?
Naturally.
It's a deal.
That's nice. I see most things from up there. Saw you arrive. Big car. Middle of night.
Right.
Wondered, who's that?
It's a perfectly natural question.
So I asked Felix.
Felix?
Felix is my friend. He hasn't been the same since the war.
Of course.
I asked him, I said, Felix, tell me, are they good or are they evil? One bark for good, two for evil.
Felix is a dog.
Do you think that I would talk to a dog? Do you think that I would ask a dog whether or not you're good or evil? What do you think I am? Some kind of a crazy backwoods lunatic with a barn full of human skulls and a scythe that I sharpen every day in readiness for Armageddon?
No, I'm sure you're just a regular kind of guy.
Right, I'm regular. I am a regular man. That's not the point. The point is, who are you? Who are you?
Well, I'm...
We're newlyweds. Are you coming back to bed soon, darling?
This is Mr. Johnson, dear.
Hello.
Pleased to meet you, ma'am.
You can call me Lucille.
It's my pleasure, Lucille.
You're not from the newspapers, are you?
No, I live up the hill.
Oh, good. But you can't tell the newspapers we're here. They never leave us alone on account of Richie.
Richie?
You recognize Richie, don't you? Richie Vanderlo? 6 gold albums, 3 platinum, 14 consecutive top 10 singles, largest selling artist worldwide for the last 12 months. Richie Vanderlo!
You have got to understand, ma'am, I watch mainly the biblical channels.
It's okay. We were married in secret in a castle in Scotland. As in England. Near Paris?
Paris.
Right. It was so romantic. We stayed there for our honeymoon, but it wasn't long enough, so we came here for the sake of a little privacy.
I see.
Would you like to come in, Mr. Johnson?
No, I better be on my way. I have to feed Felix.
Okay. Well, it was a pleasure to meet you, Mr. Johnson. See you around.
I'll catch you later then, Mr. Johnson.
Take care, Richie.
Thanks.
This?
The ransom note.
Anonymous?
Yeah.
Robert, my father knows who you are.
Oh, I never thought of that.
You are the worst kidnapper I've ever met.
Oh, and that's all I am to you, isn't it? The latest kidnapper, a lifestyle accessory. And if it doesn't work, it doesn't matter, because you can always get another one.
Quit being so melodramatic.
Well, I'm trying to do my best here under really difficult circumstances. It's not made any easier by you criticizing everything I do.
How much are you asking for?
$500,000. Yes.
U.S. dollars.
Is there a problem?
Yes, Robert. $500,000 is not a lot of money for a woman like me.
I didn't mean it as a reflection of you as an individual.
If word got out that I was liberated for $500,000, I could never show my face in polite society again.
Diamonds have no value except that which is placed upon
them. Well, it's
them.
A lot more complicated than I thought.
Okay, don't worry. All right? You're trying hard. You're keen to learn. That's important. Let's just not lose sight of the fact that we have the opportunity to make millions of dollars here.
We?
Yes, Robert. You and me.
Is that not a little irregular?
Yes, it is.
Millions?
Lisa, just give him the money! He's gonna kill me now! Please just put it in the trunk of the car! 2 miles south of me! Please, Daddy! Thank you.
Here's $40.
If you don't mind me asking, how did you know he'd react like that?
It's our job to know things like that.
You done this sort of thing before?
Let's go!
You can take the car, but remember, it's stolen.
Look, they weren't trying to kill you. They were trying to confuse you and scare you.
Yeah, before they killed me. And I lost the car and I didn't get any money.
You can't expect to get everything right the first time. Look, you are going to be fine. You are going to be a success.
Do you think so?
I mean, you didn't get caught, right?
No. No, I didn't get caught. Fooled them. I got away. Maybe we should go out.
Out where?
For a drink.
What, like on a date?
Yeah, like a date. I wouldn't call it a bad relationship. No, Lily and I, we just, you know, we just grew apart as people. There's no bitterness on either side.
She left you.
No. Yes, she left me.
The aerobics instructor.
How did you know that?
You have the demeanor of a man whose partner has left him for an aerobics instructor.
I do?
Yeah. But be honest, it was inevitable. You two weren't suited for one another. You dream of something better. She wants it now, hence the gymnast. Am I right?
Well, yeah.
Yeah, it's a common scenario.
Can I tell you about this dream I keep having? I think you're in it.
I'm in your dream? Now I feel violated.
Something like that.
I don't want to hear it.
Well, perhaps this is a good opportunity to tell you about my novel.
Look, I'm not interested in your novel.
It's 1962, right?
and Marilyn Monroe is giving birth to a baby girl. She's on the phone to Jack Kennedy. She's saying, Jack, it's yours, Jack.
So then the orphan grows up and she solves some great mystery, right? It's kind of obvious, Robert. Let's play a game. If I win, I go free.
Look, you are free. The kidnap's over. No more a kidnapper than I am, Richie Bandolo.
Indulge me, Robert.
And if it's what you want?
It's all I ever want.
You're free.
That's right.
Aren't you gonna leave?
We haven't got our money yet.
Don't take your love to town. My name is Richie Vandolo, and I'd like to sing this song for my beautiful wife, Lucille. And this is a very special song for us. Go sailing. you two young people in love.
Oh my God, what happened?
You were great.
I was? I remember drinking tequila.
Certainly was a feature of the evening.
I had an incredible dream. This dream, I've had it before. You're definitely in it now.
Oh, I don't want to hear it.
We were on this game show called Perfect Love.
Never heard of it.
Well, it's just a dream. I don't think the fact that it's a game show has any relevance. It merely indicates my cultural origins. I mean, were I a tribesman in the Kalahari, for instance, the location would undoubtedly have been different. But I think the theme is universal. We're on this game show called Perfect Love. My life was in danger.
Are you ready?
Am I ready for what?
To write a letter. Perhaps you'd like to keep this. We had it analyzed. It's his handwriting and her blood.
Without our help, Mr. Nabil, that could be the last trace of your daughter you ever see.
He wants to make it a straight switch with no delay.
I want her back.
Don't worry, we'll get her.
And I want him dead.
That's understood, Mr. Neville.
Good. Now, when this is over, I want this back.
Bradley was nice, you know, extremely wealthy. Honorable. Amusing.
And?
Well, 87 years old.
Haha, pity.
Yeah. Then there was Jake. He was nice. Very rich. Just so conventional.
You see, rich guys, conventional, it's a problem.
Then there was Angelo. 25 years old. Handsome, healthy, exciting, sophisticated, considerate.
So?
Well, I think that we just sort of grew apart as people.
The aerobics instructor.
Like I said, it's a common scenario.
So who was next?
Well, then I started getting problems with my teeth.
With your teeth?
Yeah. My teeth.
Hey, you wanna write?
Hi. Thanks for stopping, guys. So we're not stealing it, we're just borrowing it.
I had that dream again last night.
What dream?
We were on that game show called Perfect Love, right?
Fascinating.
And my life was in danger.
On a game show?
I know, it's difficult to explain. Strange things were happening.
So it would appear.
But my life was in danger. And you saved it. My heart was beating so fast. And then it stopped. And I was just about to die. And you saved it. You saved my life.
Well, what are we waiting for? You want to get on with this or not?
Sure.
You send the girl over?
Ha ha, first the money, that was the deal.
Are you okay, Miss Neville?
Yes, I'm okay. I'm just a little frightened.
Don't you worry, miss. Everything will be all right.
Well?
Okay. Send the girl over.
Fucking muscle. What took ya?
He shot up the car!
He shot up our car. Now, what did you do that for?
Trying to make a getaway.
How is she?
I don't know. But I don't think it's worked. They're not, you know.
Jeopardy, Jeopardy Jackson. Always works.
Thank you. okay?
This is far enough.
You're gonna kill me.
Yeah.
Well, then I don't see why I should dig.
If you dig, I promise you when the time comes, I'll shoot you through the head. Now look, you don't like that? I can just shoot you through the testicles right now. You can bleed to death, I'll dig the grave. It's up to you.
Can you cut me free? Please? It's sore. What's he gonna do with them?
Shoot him in the back of the head. That'd be a problem for you.
Have you ever felt like you're not in control of events?
Yes.
No. I mean, something is destined to happen, but it doesn't. Like, what happens when the forces of destiny. I'm no longer in control.
I don't know.
The truth is, I don't think even he knows what's going on down here. The chaos, this hatred, this violence.
Who are you talking about?
Jeopardy Jackson always works.
Dig.
What are they doing in there? Should have shot them myself.
Yeah, well, you can't trust them to do anything.
I take it you're not in a love situation.
What?
I mean, you're not in love.
What's it to you?
Nothing. Just asking.
That's okay, you can stop now.
No.
I've waited long enough.
Oh! Just for a minute there, I thought we were in trouble.
I told you, don't get caught. Don't get out of the car. Don't ever go into the woods with a stranger.
I know you're right.
I'm always right. You might like to remember that.
Got the money.
Policy says if the card's no good, I'm authorized to destroy it.
It's my card, lady. Listen, you don't understand right now.
I'm sorry about this, ma'am.
Don't worry. I've got some cash, okay?
$30, sir. Thank you.
Personally.
What's he trying to say, that I'm gonna find my own natural level? sink to the bottom like her?
Like who? Who are you talking about?
Pull over.
Oh no.
Trust me, I know what I'm doing.
Next. Hello. I'd like to make a withdrawal.
But we agreed on cliches. Because I don't want to die in a hospital.
I'm not going to take you to a hospital.
What? What do you mean you're not taking me to a hospital? I demand to be taken to a hospital. Why are you taking me?
Very nice. Very nice indeed.
You could have a perfect smile.
For $2,000, you could change your life.
No, thanks.
Do you think a perfect smile just happens, huh? Is that what you think? Huh? Do you think that Celine's smile is her own? No, it's not. It's mine. I gave it to her. Just like I can give you one. I'll fix your teeth for $12,000.
I didn't get shot in the teeth.
Well, let me tell you something. Wouldn't have made too much difference if you had. I don't want to say anything. I mean, it's your teeth, but if you wait another year, you're going to have like 50 grand worth of major reconstruction going on in there, so.
If you wait another year, he'll be dead.
Sorry. Just a little free consultation.
You know, they wanted me to take a break, you know. Take a break. Go get counseling, you know? Fuck them. What do they know? They wanted me to stay in the hospital. I discharged myself this afternoon. Lucky for you that I did, huh?
Okay. Have you, done this before?
The principles of surgery are the same above and below the neck. I'm sure you'll probably pass out as the pain gets worse. Some champagne?
Oh, wait.
Here you go.
Here, look at that.
So I understand that you're, here, please. I understand that you're something of a fugitive, Robert. Don't be shocked. We go back a long way.
Oh, I see. You're a dentist.
Yeah, that's right. We met over that particularly fine set of ivories. In fact, I gave her her first filling.
Now I have to hurt you with this inconvenient and undignified.
Fucker. Get up!
Leave him alone, Elliot.
Why don't you stay out of this?
Exactly what you were trying to achieve back there.
How about you do some explaining to me?
I didn't want you to bleed to death, and I think I saved your life.
Yeah, well, I would rather have bled to death than have witnessed that.
Witness what exactly?
You and Elliot in an advanced state of foreplay.
He was about to pass out drunk in about 5 minutes if you hadn't come along.
Yes, it's true.
And even if we were about to get physical, which we weren't, what's it got to do with you anyway? You thought we had something.
It's possible.
But why? Why, Robert? Why do we have to have something? We were getting along just fine. Having something ruins everything. What are you gonna do now? Ask me to marry you?
Of course I'm not gonna ask you to marry me.
But you thought about it.
Don't be absurd.
It never even occurred to you.
Well, it wouldn't be so bad.
See what I mean? Just forget it.
Consider it forgotten.
Where do you want to go?
Don't care.
Do you want to get out of the car?
You're asking me to get out of the car.
No, I'm asking if you want to get out.
The same thing.
It's not the same thing. One is a request, the other's a question.
Fine. If that's what you want, then I'll get out.
No, if that's what you want, I won't stop you.
And don't even ask where I'm going.
Don't even imagine that I care.
Exactly the problem.
Stop hovering over me. I can't concentrate.
Have you written anything yet?
What am I supposed to write?
Love letters, Jackson, deal mainly with the subject of love.
I need time to think.
We don't have time. Every day they spin apart, the more difficult it's going to be. And if Neville finds our boy, he's just meat.
Back when I was alive, there was a girl.
You wrote to some girl?
A long time ago.
You never told me about this.
Never came to nothing, O'Reilly. Her father did not approve a match. It was just young love, but I won't. Many times, passion and despair.
I never knew you had a romantic soul.
I often wonder what became of that girl. Sweet Eliza. Eliza Gray. Her father was a colonel.
Jackson, you're qualified. You can write this letter.
That's a problem. See, I wrote to her, sure, but I didn't write letters. As a matter of fact, I wrote love poems.
want one thing. Maybe they want it more than once, but it's still only one thing.
I just never could return. You were always on my mind. You were always on my mind.
I wish you'd let me read that poem.
Poem? Very personal document.
Well, I hope it was a good one. That's all I'm saying. Because if she don't like it, she won't come. And if she don't come, we're stuck.
Sir.
The one you wrote me?
Poem.
Oh, desert me, wretched loneliness, and bring me back my love.
For she and I have parted. The sky is up above.
It worked. She loves it.
Your limbs so svelte and slender. Your touch so soft and tender. But the bits that I like best are the bits that I'm gonna read that line.
Jackson, what the hell did you write?
No, it was a,
Yeah?
A simple poetic reference to,
Oh!
Oh!
Sorry. Oh!
Please, last verse. Just as the flowers blossom in the gaze of the shining sun, I would be most honored if you would bear my son. Robert, no one has ever written me a poem before. All those guys I dated, they didn't care about me. They just wanted to own this.
I would never open my heart to any of those guys.
And before I met you, I never believed that there was any alternative. But when you stopped that bullet, and then you got the wrong idea about Elliot, I should have understood.
Celine.
No, please, just let me finish. This is very difficult for me to say.
But I feel I can trust you.
I didn't write the poem.
What?
I didn't write it. Never written a poem in my life.
How can anybody be that honest?
It's his handwriting. Tell him it's his handwriting.
But it's your handwriting. It has this address. It even has some sort of cheap aftershave impregnated on the paper.
I didn't write the poem, okay?
God.
Selene, there's no need to...
Human fucking beings. What do you have to do?
We did everything for them. We brought them together. We put them in jeopardy. We damn near killed them both. We gave them every opportunity. All I had to do was fall in love.
Maybe we failed, Jackson. But we don't have to live like this.
Looking woman.
She isn't my type.
What are you talking about? Look at yourself. You're nobody. You're nothing. You're wanted in connection with a violent crime. You're cleaning the floor of a diner. She is an intelligent, passionate, beautiful, rich woman. The issue of whether or not she is your type, not one that you are likely to have to resolve in this world. Or indeed the next, since she will be going to some heaven for glamorous pussy. And you will be cleaning the floor of a diner in hell. I guess so. So why are you even thinking about it? I don't know. Where's the floor?
Straight off. Not till we send a few of your fingers to the mail.
16. I'm gonna stick right there. Let's see, how about you? You are here? No. No, Mr. Veal. You got a five-card trick, Mr. Veal. You can stick right there, and you got $4,000. But you want another hit. Okay, you want another hit, it's up to you. What is that?
It's rejection.
I can't do that. I'm playing blackjack. She might cheat while I'm in the room. Thank you.
All right. I'll answer the door. You play blackjack with a hostage.
Now, you sure you want to increase your bet before you take another hit?
Now cut her free. Everything all right. I'm just trying to explain to you that for all I knew, she could have been a karate expert or something.
With a broken arm. With a broken arm!
Okay, I'm sorry. Now just cut her free! Celine?
What do you want?
I'm just trying to explain.
No! Despite your crummy home, I came to see you. And all you could do was humiliate me and turn me away. I thought you were decent. I thought you were different, but you're not. You're just a lying, cheating son of a bitch, just like all the rest.
Stay! I'm going to die! I don't know her other poem, but I'll tell you! Feelings!
Oh, sure!
Not so easy now!
Celine, everything's going to be just fine. Well, we're not just gonna leave him here, are we?
No, sir.
Come in.
think they're coming back.
Isn't there anything you can do?
I don't have the authority to intervene. I don't have the authority to intervene!
Canoe, sir. But I think it's upstairs. I think it's upstairs. I would have put it up there. We probably left it under the bed. That would be a good place.
I don't think he has it, Mr. Neville.
No, that's it. That's what it is. That's what it was. I put it under that board. I'll have your money back to you in a minute, Mr. Neville, sir. Board up. Then we'll get it back to you.
It was just enough to face the truth, Robert. You don't have my money.
Yeah, it's down here, all right, Mr. Neville, sir. Just where I left it.
But frankly, I don't care. Just a detail.
You have your money back in a second, sir.
Don't you understand that it isn't the money, it's the principle.
Could anything be beyond your control?
Well, anyway, you shot them, and then you shot Sure, he didn't move.
I'm quite sure, sir. Yes, sir. No, sir. Sir, please.
Yeah, right. Yeah, right. Maybe she's moved. She's moved. I saw it with my own eyes.
Yes, sir. Thank you, sir. They are both dead, sir. I shot them myself. I won't disturb you again.
Who's that? Robert?
You shot them, and then you shot yourself, and then you set fire to this cabin, didn't you?
Not yet, he didn't.
Celine? Why don't you just put that gun down?
Do not get in my way, Father.
Celine, you're not responsible for your actions. You're unhinged.
You need the best psychiatric treatment that money can buy, just like your mother. So why don't you...
As he dreamt, I shall save his life with an arrow of my love for him.
Kill him, are you?
Successful relationships are made in heaven, not founded on the daily practicality of two people being prepared to tolerate the imperfections of one another.
It's not successful relationships, Celine. It's love. And it comes from a strange and wonderful place that we don't know about.
So then you also reject the idea that love is merely an emotional adaptation to a physical necessity.
Completely.
Are you serious?
Fate intervenes in people's lives.
In ours, for instance.
Fate brought us together. It kept us together. We were destined for one another.
Fate had a pretty strange way of making its point.
But that's part of the beauty of it. It's inexplicable, unpredictable, and absolutely beyond control or understanding.
You nearly got killed.
But I didn't. And here we are.
Do you have any substantial evidence to back all of this?
None at all.
And you realize that it's absurd and irrational.
I know that.
Then why do you believe it?
Because, Celine, I'm a dreamer.
Well, I guess that makes two of us.
Are you ready?
As I'll ever be.
Then let's go.
Thank you. was it?
Believe me, Gabriel. You don't want to know.
But it worked.
Yeah. Love. Worked.
Amaratus pectum laborium.
Are we going home now?
We're going home.
golden dregs on a riptide, freaks ride.